Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, civilians of all ages, what's poppin'? Animated Establishment Townsy, bringing y'all my live reaction. Chapter 129 of The Promised Neverland, Yosuke no Neverlando. It's time. Now, last chapter, we found out Emma and Ray, they about to go on a solo mission. They gotta go to the Seven Walls, find out how to make a new promise, come back. All before Norman decide he wanna execute all the royal families. Now, my boy Josh was in the comments saying that maybe Norman pushes the plan forward faster to do what he needs to do before Emma gets back. Now, I don't think he's going to do that because he has at least a little trust for Emma. And if his plan goes like how it does, he shouldn't need to. But Emma has seen that Norman has been shouldering basically the weight of all it is by himself. And she's trying to de-stress, take some of that off, take the load off, be like, hey, come on, bro, we can work in this together. That's what we fold, that's what the family's fold, that's what we grew up for, we worked through this together. We come out with a great solution. We don't gotta do mass genocide. I'm never believing genocide, not even in like Emma's case, personally. I ain't never one to like think about like genocide. Hell to the no, like that's crazy, like. Like, even if it's a race that's trash, like the demons or whatever, like, shit could be reprimanded. I believe that shit could be reprimanded. But we're going to go ahead and get to this chapter because I'm impatient. I'm trying to see why my man Norman is down here. You know what I mean? Stressing right now. Recalling that day, his friend's voices are so distant now. So Norman sent down his hands in his face. It doesn't matter what you tell me. I've already made up my mind. I can't afford to make any mistakes. And I won't let anybody die, so he's thinking about the day that he had to leave. Norman, and they all looking at him. Ray, Emma, See, the reason I'm thinking that Norman is so torn is because obviously during this time when he was experimented on with all the demons and stuff like that, he has had a completely separate experience than Emma and them have. Yes, Emma and them have been fighting demons, but Norman has been under the control of demons, under the watch of demons this entire time. Their attitudes and stuff like that, their thoughts, their motives. Norman might have like a little bit more of an insight on that and how they think and if they'll stop or not. But as we know, Emma's met people that have stopped and that don't care. Obviously, homeboy that was a musician was like, I want to eventually taste some human again or whatever. But that was a want. He wasn't like, I need to. And musician don't need to. It's a, you know what I mean? Where there's a will, there's a way. But I think since they went through different experiences, it's why they're having this turmoil right now. And again, I think this is just a big point of characterization for Norman because he's going to have to choose. Whether it's Emma, the love, or, I mean, his plan with his friends and stuff like that, with his new friends and stuff like that, not separating them, but with the friends that went through the experiences that he did. Now, obviously, I think since he decided not to stop his plan, he's not willing to just go willy-nilly with whatever Emma says. But I still think since he's having a conflict with himself right now. If he's having an inner conflict with himself right now, it's definitely not going to stop him from having one later when he do decide to put the royal clans to death. But we're gonna go ahead and keep reading. I only got one page in and I'm still talking like a motherfucker. My bad. Oh damn, so are we about to see the like experiments and things that we, oh sweet Jesus, this looks crazy. This page, you see all experiments, humans chained up and shit, they numbered up, these papers everywhere, it's like doctors experiments every day, their lives were steeped in blood. Jesus Christ, like monster scientists and shit. Chapter 129, Something I Should Carry. And then so Norman and Zazie walking down the steps, and then he opened this big ass door. Yo, boss, I was looking for y'all. What's that? They got a big ass demon just chained up, dying and shit. What is that? Bruh, why? Where? Why? What is that? What is that? But they all looking at this motherfucker huge, dog. In battle, are we fighting these? Like, are we gonna have to fight some of these? God damn, they just got a barrel of crowbars. Is that what they had to use? Is that what they fought them with, some crowbars? Is it alive or is it like dead? It can't be alive. Nah, that mug dead. It gotta be. It's been a while since I've come here. They say I come here quite a bit myself. It always manages to calm me down to see a dead demon. It always manages to calm me down. And then he looks into the fire. What'd they want to talk about? Various things. I wonder if Norman's about to spill the beans. because they not here right now. He can say it without them being mad. But whatever, when they come back and then they might be mad or whatever. Whatever. Norman's friends seem like some mad ass individuals. That's all I gotta say. Them not wanting to let the demons go extinct being one of them. So they really? So what happens now, boss? Don't be impatient. There will be no change to the plan. And also, the evil blood maiden is alive. And they are all like, gasp! They're like, huh? Ain't that bad? I've thought about it a bit. Leave it to me. Alright. Give them a little chance or whatever. It seems that she's friends with Emma and her acquaintances. And they like, huh? Like, they are lost. Alright, so Norman is spilling the beans. Okay, so ain't no secrets nowhere. It's not happening like that. Okay. So we not hiding nothing from nobody. It's all out in the air. I like that. Friends with the cursed blood? These could either be very good or very bad circumstances. So that's why, huh? Because she really doesn't want to kill the demons. Why? Friends with the demons? What the hell is that? Yeah, I mean, they wouldn't be alive if it wasn't for demons. Demons aren't like that. There's no way, right? Yeah, there's just no way. You know what I mean? Emma's just a liar. Emma's just a liar. Norman, you are you calling Emma a liar? There's no way. I'm just saying. I know Norman ain't talking this right now. But Norman, you didn't let her say that? And then we cut back to whatever house she was at. And then her and the old boy was about to leave, I'm assuming. And then they're one of the ones that got experimented on too. And that's unfortunate. And then obviously it was the demons that was experimented on. She starts screaming, grabs her head. Like I said, all these people went through way different experiences with the demons than they did. But y'all didn't meet friendly demons. And she's like, ah, damn it. It's here. My head, it's splitting open. And like, Barbara, she's having the usual spasms, damn it. Damn, that's all bad. So she got PTSD with that shit too. That's unfortunate. The intervals between them has been getting less and less within the past few days. Not just her, but for all of us. Where's the medicine? It's in my room for all of y'all. Bro, they all have these PTSD ass symptoms. I wonder if Norman be having them PTSD ass symptoms. I wonder if, like, I know he was thinking to himself about other things when he had his head in his hands. But I wonder if, like, that was going through his mind too. I have some in reserve. Here, take it, Barbara. And then so he just dump out like 7 pills in his hand and she take all them hoes. God damn. The amount of medicine needed has increased. And it's not just the frequency getting worse, but the symptoms too. We very well could have little time left. What? I see. See, this is what demons are. We're just livestock to them. It's only natural. This is what demons are to us cattle, damn it. And so they all look, you know what I mean, they surprised. They all sad and shit. If only the demons didn't exist. Hey, boss. When you were gone, we talked with Emma and Ray. They're nice kids. But that sweet talk they spewed out disgusted me. They're nice people. They really are. And then he looks over. Even so, you're on our side, right, boss? So, we splitting sides. Don't do this to Norman. Don't do this to Norman. This is what I was talking about. Characterization. Who is he gonna choose? Old friends or new friends? No. Number boy. You're the boss, aren't you? Losing your ways is something you can do right. Losing your ways is something you can do right. Norman, how are you before this? Losing your way? You can't lose your way. What Norman were you first? What Norman were you first? Ain't no losing your way. Cause that'd be faux as fuck to say lose. Nah, I shouldn't say that. But it's not fake. But it's like, that's not this. Boss, that's not boss. This is Norman. Losing your way. He already lost his way. He ain't Norman no more. He's boss. And then Norman looked down at him. He's still looking at him. And then he said, we've come this far. Of course there's no stopping now. He didn't say nothing about sides. Nothing like that. He just said the plan is still in motion. As of now, the plan is still in motion. He did brush it off real nice. I see you, Norman. Smart. He's still smart. And he still got away with words. These people, again, I'm assuming that they were the smart ones in relatively wherever they were from, whatever farms. They were the smart ones. That's why they were chosen to be experimented on. I wonder if they picked up on that just like I did. Because all Norman did was brush that off. February 2047. So, is this a flashback? I believe it's a flashback. This is it. Lambda's research data? This isn't enough. But it does have records on most of us cattle. Depending on what demons eat, how do they mutate? How do they regenerate and degenerate? How they die? We really don't have enough data on you demons. And then so, they just got fucking jars and shit. They got demon intestines, heads, eyeballs, brains. Did they get it all from this dude? This is just one demon right here? Because this is the room that they was all talking in just now. The room with all those brains and shit. I haven't lost my way. Everything from the beginning. I decided to do this alone. You can't. All of this is something that I should carry alone. Emin Ray are kind, but kindness won't bring victory in this world. In reality, if I didn't choose to get shipped out, all of us wouldn't have been able to escape. And I have no regrets. So as we going back to the beginning, you're going to try to sacrifice yourself again? I think Emma's whole thing about that whole sacrifice is she's just not going to let it happen. She's just not going to let it happen, bro. You just stop trying to sacrifice yourself. Why are you trying to sacrifice yourself so bad? Why we can't just, like, work together? I don't get it. Why must people just make things harder? You got to be smarter than average, bro, boo-boo. Why we can't just work together, come up with a solution together? We can work this out. Communication, we got this. Just talk. I'm not talking about between the demons and them. Just talk between us humans on how we can do the situation. You know what I mean? All of us, just say words. All the kids got... You think kids gonna lie about the... Ask the kids, bro. Ask the little kids. Y'all think the little kids gonna lie about seeing some nice demons? Ask the little kids. Oh, God. They gonna be like, yeah, they good. They good. They nice. Oh, well, whatever. I wanna save them. Emma, Sislo, and all the rest of our comrades. And for that reason, he's alone. On the path to atonement. Oh, shit. I'll gladly become a god or a devil if I have to. Emma. And so we get this dope ass panel of Grim Reaper slash Angel Norman, and he has his little lamp of death. He has a wing. He's hooded. He's half skeleton. This is clean. this is clean as fuck. Norman's ready to again sacrifice it all for the sake of everything. I do think that's foreshadowing to the fact that he's going to try, but I think this time, damn. That's foreshadowing. I think that he's going to try to do some bullshit. And just like before, Emma's going to try to stop him. But she failed that. She failed at that last time. This time she's not. She's going to smack shit out that man. Come to your senses. We're going to save the demons too. We're going to save ourselves. Everybody going to live. And everybody going to get up out of here, goddamn me. Shit. Just work together. Just talk. Communication, we got this, you know what I mean? We humans, we could work together. We were working at this for years, millennia. Communication, that's the downfall of our civilization, shit. But either way, along with all the other Shonen Jump manga, The Promised Neverland has also been on a tear. We did get to finally see a tiny bit more into like Norman's past, how they were experimenting on and stuff like that. I want to see like more of what they went through, because I understand like there was the experimentations they got tested on and stuff like that, but the demons warped all of their minds. There has to be a little something more than that. The demons warped their minds. There is no way like they are this crazy. They're going crazy now. Even Norman, even like he went from, obviously he sacrificed himself before he thought he was gonna die, but even Norman right now. It's like he remembers. He went through some shit. They did not say that he was exempt from those medicine issues, PTSD stuff. So Norman has had the same experiences as far as the experimentations goes as these people, and he can completely understand where they're coming from. And that's why I believe Norman is so big when it comes to his characterization right now. And whatever his choice is really going to matter. Whether Emma stops him or not, that's another thing. But whatever choice he makes in the first place is going to matter heavy. Because he still hasn't said what side he's on. I don't believe in sides anyways, but he still hasn't said what side he's on. He just said the plan ain't gonna stop. Just like he told Emma and them. You know what I mean? They tried to stop him from being a god or whatever. And then these people continuously... I like the differences between this and last chapter. It's basically Emma and them saying what they want. And then his group and them saying what they want. And it's like with Norman's sides clashing with each other. And now we get to see what's going on. We get to see what's really going on. So I'm excited for next chapter to see what's going on. But as far as this live reaction goes... Finish all I got for y'all this time around. So like I always say, leave a like, comment, subscribe, pull up to the Twitch stream, pull up to the Discord, and y'all have a good one.